Ciao a tutti! Tell me the truth. Have you ever entered in a library that was not a library? Don't worry, because we have all been victims of some falsi amici, at least once. For falsi amici, we mean those words that are similar in various languages in terms of pronunciation, but which have different meanings. The list of falsi amici could be very, very long. For today's video, I have selected some of the most insidious for you. So let's take a closer look at them. First one. Argument, argomento. If an Italian tells to you that he wants to talk about un argomento, don't be worried. In fact, he probably just wants to offer you new ideas for discussion. Argomento in Italian means topic or subject, and it has no aggressive connotation. C'è un argomento che voglio discutere oggi in riunione. There is a topic that I won't like to discuss today in a meeting. Or un argomento veramente interessante. A really interesting topic. Now, how do you translate argument in Italian? You can translate argument with litigio, from the verb litigare, to argue. Ho avuto un litigio con il mio capo. I had an argument with my boss. Or, ho litigato con il mio ragazzo. I argued with my boyfriend. Second one. Eventually, eventualmente. When in Italian we say that something eventualmente si farà, we indicate a situation of uncertainty, where the final result depends on some circumstances that are not certain to occur. The meaning of eventualmente is in the hypothesis, or let's imagine that se eventualmente passo il colloquio per il nuovo lavoro, cambio città. In the hypothesis that I will pass the interview for the new job, I will change city. Or, se eventualmente la febbre non si abbassa, chiamo il dottore. In the case the fever does not go down, I call a doctor. Instead, the word eventually can be translated in Italian with alla fine or prima o poi. Immaginavo che alla fine saresti arrivato. I imagined that you would eventually arrive. But one more clarification. We say alla fine o finalmente. Alla fine is used to indicate something that happens at the end, after something else. Alla fine ho deciso di trasferirmi, non mi piaceva il mio quartiere. In the end, I decided to move, I didn't like my neighborhood. Finalmente expresses satisfaction for the realization of a long-awaited event. Finalmente sei arrivato. You finally arrived. Or, ho finalmente trovato la casa dei miei sogni. I finally found my dream home. Third one, rumor, rumore. Ho sentito, I heard, un rumore. Tells your Italian friend and maybe you wait for the rest. But in vain. Yes, because rumore in Italian simply means noise. If you want to start a discussion with someone who has told something about someone else, in this case the right Italian word is pettegolezzo. Pettegolezzo. Ho un pettegolezzo sulla nostra nuova collega. I have a rumor to tell you about our new colleague. There is also another term in Italian which has a similar but less malicious meaning, and it's chiacchiera. Fare quattro chiacchiere, it's a cute expression to say speaking informally. But chiacchiera in Italy and in Italian is also a typical dessert for the carnival period. Fourth, parent, parente. In this case, the mistake is not so sensational. In fact, we always stay in the family. Simply, il parente in Italian doesn't refer to the mother or to the father. Mother and father are called i genitori. Un parente can be an uncle, aunt, the cousin, brother or sister. In short, a person of our large family, a relative. Luigi è un mio parente che non ho visto da anni. Luigi is a relative of mine who I haven't seen for some years. Sono molto legata ai miei genitori, anche se sono adulta li chiamo ogni giorno. I'm very close to my parents. Even if I am adult, I call them every day. Yes, I'm a very Italian daughter. Fifth, actually, attualmente. Let's try to make things clear. Actually in Italian corresponds to in realtà. And just like in English, it is often used to start a sentence. In realtà io ho pensato a un'altra idea per il compleanno di Sabrina. Actually, I thought another idea for Sabrina's birthday. While we say attualmente to mean currently. Ho saputo che Giorgio è in Spagna attualmente. I learned that Giorgio is currently in Spain. Sixth, preservatives, preservativi. We end up with one of the funniest falsi amici. If reading the ingredients of a food prepared to an Italian friend, you mention i preservativi, don't be surprised that he makes that face. Preservativo in Italian means condom. The correct word to say preservatives is conservanti. Questa zuppa è piena di conservanti. This soup is full of preservatives. To sum up our falsi amici, libreria, it's bookshop. Biblioteca, it's library. Argomento, it means topic. Litigio, it's an argument. Alla fine, it's eventually or in the end. Eventualmente, we can translate with in the hypothesis or in case of. Finalmente, finally. Rumore, noise. Pettegolezzo or chiacchiera, it means rumor. Attualmente is currently. In realtà, actually. Parente is relative. Genitore is parent. Conservante is preservative. And preservativo is condom. Alla prossima! See you soon!